And nicely I have explained this chapter to you and you have practiced also. So children, today I will do some revision of this chapter. In the examination children, you are having two parts like that, objective type of question and then subjective type of question. In objective type of question children, you have to click on the correct option. For one question, there will be the four option, out of which only one option is correct, okay? So that right option only you have to click. And then there will be the true and false also, whether this statement is true or whether this statement is false, that also you have to take it, okay? So it is very easy. You can do it. And then there is some subjective questions where the word problem will come, some simplification will come, and then some problem of your, not of your size, it maybe internal type problem will come, maybe that data will be changed but the problem will be same. So what you will do children, you will practice each and every question of the example. Means you have to understand the problem. If the number is also changed, then you can do, no? So you have to only understand the problem, then you have to solve it. Not simply only you have to learn it. Okay, maths, we are not learning maths, we are understanding. So with the help of some examples only, today we are going to revise this chapter. Whole parts and decimal. So some part of this chapter today we will revise, and in next class again we will continue with it. So here we are going to take some question. Like that, here is the question: what decimal do the following shaded and unshaded part represent? So here is the given. This picture is divided into 10 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, 10 equal parts. And then 8 part of it is shaded. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and this 8 part is shaded here, okay? And 2 part is unshaded. Now here is the question, you have to write down the decimal of the shaded part and unshaded part. What you have to do? What are the decimals do the following shaded and unshaded part represent? That you have to write. So first you know how to write it as a fraction. So first you will write as a fraction only. So for unshaded, for shaded part, what you will do? It will be 8 by 10. 8 part is shaded now. And then unshaded part is 2 by 10. Now children, 8 by 10 means 10th, okay, 8 10th, and 8 10th we are writing like this, 0.8, okay, and here it will be 0.2, means 8 part after decimal, what the number is coming, that means it is the 8 part of 10 equal division, okay, so 0.8 and 0.2 we have written as a decimal. Now the next question is, write the base value and expanded form of
Thank you.
10th we are denoting by small t and 100th we are denoting by small h. So here we can write here ones, small t for tens means the first place after decimal point, and then small h for hundreds, that is the second place after the decimal point. Here it will be 3.5. Now we have to write in a write the place value of this. So what is the place value of this 5? This 5 is in 10th place, so you will multiply this 5 with 0.1. That means it is 0.5, and we can write this as a 5/10. Okay. Next 3 is in 1's place, so we will multiply by 1, and 3 into 1 equal to 3, that means 3 1's. So we have written the place value of these digits, okay? Now we have to write in an expanded form. What? We are writing the number in the expanded form as its place value. Separate place value we are writing like this, okay? So you can see here 3.5 is what? 3 ones plus 5 tens, that will be now. And 3 ones we can write as a 3 here, and 5 tens we can write as a 0.5. So this is the expanded form of 3.5, okay? Now we are going to solve this. 2.37. We have to write the place value of 2.37. Here also same we will do. Okay, we can give this is the A number, this one, and now we are going to do this one, B number. So 2.37 first we will write in a place value table. So we are going to make a place value table here, 1, 10, and 100. Okay? This is the place value table. Okay? Now 2 ones. So we are going to write 2 ones here. The first place after the decimal point, this is the decimal point, are known as tens place. So we will write it here to be, and then 100 will be at 7. Okay? Now we are going to write the place value. Same. Okay? 7 into what we will do, because it is 100th place. Means the second place after the decimal points. So we will multiply it by 0.01. Okay? And then it will be 0.07, and we can write it as the 700. Okay? Now this 3. 3 is in 10th place, so we will multiply it 0.1, it will be 0.03, and we can write it as a 3/10. Okay? Then we will multiply this 2 with 1's, because it is in 1's place, and it will be 2, and we can write it as a 2 1's. Okay? Now we are going to write in an expanded form. So for expanded form, we will write like this: 2.37 is equal to 2 ones, that is 2 ones plus 3 tens and 700. So like that, we can write the place value and the expanded form of decimal number. Okay. So if any decimal number will come, maybe they are also having a different digit, not same. So you can do it, okay? Now we will learn how to write the number names. Already you are knowing only, okay? How to write the number name. What we are reading, that only we are writing. And we are reading the decimal like this. This is the whole part. This is the decimal point. Okay, we can denote by the point. This is the decimal point. means whole number you know only how to read and how to write. You have learned the number names. Now up to I think 7 is the number. You know how to write and how to read it. Now for the decimal number, means the number which comes after the point, we are simply reading the numbers separately, not together. Like that, if it is written 62, we will not call 62. We will say 62. Okay, like that we are reading. Okay, not we are saying 62, we are saying 62. Here we will not say 1, we will say 01. Whatever is written, written over there, we will read separately, and that only we are going to write. So you know how to write the whole number, whole part. Easy for you, that you know only. So you will write here 12. And for this decimal points, we will write simple point. And then here it is 1. 12.1. This is 2. Then point. And then here it will be 6-2. Okay, we will say, read separately like this. 6-2. Each digit, each number, we will write separately. 6-2. Okay, if more is there than 3. Here it will be 200. Here we are not writing like that. 213. We are writing like 230. But if there is a decimal point, we will read like this, 213, 0.213, okay? So here it is 213. how to write the name of the decimal, how to write the place value, how to write in expanded form, and how to write in a number line. Okay, we have revised today. So in next class we will revise another misconversion of fraction to decimal and decimal to fraction. So keep on practicing. Thank you. Have a nice day.